Hi, what's up? My name is Emily, and I've been putting this off for hours.
I have like 4 other videos that I should actually be finishing, but instead I'm doing another one of these What I Ate in a Week videos. This is, I believe, the 5th one that I've ever made in my lifetime.
As you can see, it's been very interesting so far. I've put some oats into a bowl, and now I'm putting some almond milk in there, and I'm gonna microwave it. I also put some apples in there before I microwaved it, but for some reason I forgot to film that part. So you can just, you know, imagine it happening. And then after I took it out of the microwave, I put in some chia seeds, raisins, pecans, and some stevia. I'm just trying not to eat as much sugar and maple syrup as I usually do. And then for lunch, I came home and had some leftover soup. And this is one of the least appetizing meals of looking. The least aesthetic looking meals of the video you're gonna see today.
But it's really good soup. It was a soup mix from a place in Fresno called Sierra Nut House. They have soup mixes and most of them are vegan.
And also I had some leftover veggies dipped in spicy hummus from a local Mediterranean market.
And then during my class, I had a snack and it was a fig bar. This is the flavor raspberry. They also come in apple and blueberry. I think we got them at Costco.
I don't know.
They're basically just Fig Newtons, but like bigger.
And then for dinner, this is onions and garlic and oil being sauteed or what, caramelized, whatever you want to say. And I'm just making some tofu and veggies that I'm going to add to some noodles, leftover noodles from the night before. It's kind of like a chow mein-ish thing, except don't get mad at me because I'm not trying to say it's like authentic or anything. I'm just saying that's something sort of similar that it was similar to. But I use spaghetti noodles, which I know is like, wow, come at me, but like, yeah, that's all we had in the house, and I wanted to use up some of the veggies that we had, so I was like, oh, why don't I just make some noodle stir fry with some veggies? And I was like, well, all we have is spaghetti. And I was like, do I want to be a disgrace? And then I was like, do I want food? And then I was like, yes. And so I made it. And this is tofu, the way that I make it when I'm too lazy to make it a good way. Although I do think this is still really tasty also. I basically just crumble it into the pan with oil and put like Bragg's and salt and pepper on it and whatever else I'm feeling for the day. And then just stir it around a lot until it gets browned and sort of crispy. Like, honestly, I could just eat tofu fried a little bit with a little bit of oil and some Bragg's, and that is, like, so good to me. I don't know if that's just me or if that's, like, the secret to life. It's probably just me. But, and I'll just add it into whatever I'm eating. And then this is the onions with, I mixed in the sprouts, bean sprouts, and a cabbage mix that I got. Like super cheap, little cabbage and carrots mix. And then I put in some vegan oyster sauce and soy sauce. The oyster sauce isn't like necessary, but I like it. It makes things taste better. And then I'm mixing in the spaghetti stuff. And yeah, that's it. So pretty good meal. Nothing special, just like me wanting Asian food but being white and lazy, and only having spaghetti. So and then Tuesday morning, love that store. I actually don't. It makes me feel really uncomfortable in there. I feel like I'm in like a haunt, like a horror movie waiting to happen. But I'm just putting an apple in a bag. It didn't fit in the bag, the big one. Never mind, you don't need to know. Yeah, so I packed an apple, basically. That's all you need to know. And then I ate 2 leftover muffins that my mom made the other day. They were like banana muffins, and she tried to use half the sugar, like half the sugar in the recipe, and then replace the other half with some stevia, and it actually worked out really well. They were just a little bit denser than they probably would have normally been, but they were really good. I'll ask her what recipe she used, because I know you guys will ask for it, and I'll post it in the comments or in the description or something. And then for lunch, yes, this is lunch. For lunch, I had the leftover noodles, basically. That's all you need to know. Yeah. And then for a snack, I had this Kashi Snickerdoodle bar, almond butter bar or whatever.
I thought it was pretty good. It's not like super sweet, but that's like kind of a good thing because, you know, try not to eat as much sugar, but,
And then another snack I had was some pita bread. It was half of like a pita round and, carrots and celery and spicy hummus again. The best hummus that I've ever, probably my favorite hummus that I've ever eaten in my life is this spicy hummus from the market that I'm gonna put the text on the screen because I don't know how to pronounce anything. For dinner, I had Chinese leftovers, brown rice, chow fun noodles, vegetarian broccoli beef, although I don't even think there was any of the actual beef left, just broccoli, and then some vegetarian orange chicken. It's from Little Peking, one of my favorite places to go in Clovis, and yeah.
And then I had one of these Meyer lemon cups, which apparently they sell at Costco in like a big pack now, and they're really, really good. They're like raw vegan. I don't know if they actually like officially raw, but they're like those no bake pie or no bake cheesecake kind of things. But it's a lemon tart and it's pretty coconutty and pretty lemony. But if you like those, it's super good. A nice portion control also if you want to have like a little dessert, but you don't want to like, you know, get crazy on a Tuesday night. And then Wednesday morning, I had one more muffin as I was like making my breakfast because I was already hungry, and I made a smoothie with some frozen strawberries, frozen bananas, some peanut butter, and some soy milk. And that's it. And that's very fascinating. Kind of looks like cubby custard. I embrace it, you know? I love cubby custard. I always wanted to try it when I was a kid watching Teletubbies. What does cubby custard taste like? And then for lunch, I was taking lunch to school like a good kid. This is a chickpea salad sandwich. You've seen me make it before, most likely, because I've made it a million times on this channel. Recipe is from Oshi Glows. And it's a really good recipe that I make a lot, and I just put spinach in the sandwich. It's great. I love it. My favorite. And then I had some lemonade. And then I on the way home from, or when actually on the way to the parking lot, I had another one of those Kashi bars. And then for dinner on Wednesday, I made pasta. I have eaten spaghetti, I think, 5 days of this video, which is just crazy, but in, like, different ways. That was a lot of zucchini, because we had a lot of zucchini, and I don't really like zucchini very much, so I always chop it up into tiny pieces so I don't have to, like, get a huge chunk of it, if that makes sense. And then a bunch of tomatoes, and this is, like, half of a can of tomato puree, tomato sauce, and then some seasoning. I don't know, some olive oil, garlic, this Gardein beefless stuff, which was kind of freezer burnt and honestly didn't taste that great as it should have, but it wasn't like bad. And once it was like mixed in, it was, you don't care. Why am I saying this? No one, I always share way too many details that really like don't need to be shared. I put a bunch of nutritional yeast in it. I put a bunch of spinach in it, and now my screen went black and I don't know why. Anyways, I put it on top of spaghetti noodles. I ate it with my mom. It was pretty good. Not the best thing that I've ever made in my life, but it was. I love tomatoes, so as you can imagine, I enjoyed it. I also had some Ben & Jerry's PB&N peanut butter. What is it called? PB&N cookies. Ice cream while FaceTime with Casey, where she was eating ice cream too in San Jose. How cute. And then Thursday morning, I had some cereal. I had some of these berry bunnies from Annie's Organic and some Cascadian Farms Cinnamon Crunch, basically the vegan and slightly healthier version of Cinnamon Toast Crunch. Also some Mystic Mango kombucha. I love kombucha. It's one of the things that I feel necessary to splurge on because it's just so good. It really helps to wake me up in the morning, give me that little extra boost of, I don't know what, it's just kind of like, woo, carbonation and the flavor, strong flavor. Also, I packed 3 balls, the chocolate ones from the video. They were the balls that I showed in my snack video that I just made, the What's in My Backpack snack video. So that's what I was taking to school. And I also had, I came home and had a chickpea salad sandwich with some spinach and toasted bread. And then
I also had a snack of celery and hummus. This is the same hummus as the other one, except this one's not spicy. And then I had two little clementine-y things. And then I had some leftover pasta. This is such a fascinating video, isn't it? And I also had another one of these Hail Mary Meyer lemon cups. They are delicious, and I recommend them. Friday morning, I made a smoothie with frozen strawberries, frozen bananas, and frozen blueberries, and a bunch of almond milk. And then I just blended that until it was blended, and I put a little bit of protein powder. This is soy protein powder from Trader Joe's, the cheapest protein powder that I've ever been able to find in store, and it's not disgusting tasting. And a little bit of peanut butter. To me, that's a little bit. I don't know what a little bit looks like to you guys, but to me, that's a small amount. That's like, I'm in control today. And so that was my breakfast. Pretty friggin' exciting, I know. And later in the day. Oh, and Friday, this is the day that I filmed the snack video. So basically my lunch was just me eating a bunch of snacks. And then for dinner, I had more leftover pasta. This is before I microwaved it, except I added a bunch more spinach. And I was trying to get rid of this Trader Joe's cheese because it's going bad soon. But I put way too much and it was not that great. I don't think this is necessarily like a bad product, like that it's just disgusting. But you definitely shouldn't use very much of it, so I have learned. And then I had some veggie straws, and I think I had some other snacks, some other chips too, like sweet chili Doritos or something. And then I ate a little bit, like a few bites of the PB and cookies.
Non-dairy frozen dessert, Ben and Jerry's ice cream.
On Saturday, I went back to the good old classic Emily breakfast that I used to always eat, and I don't know why I stopped eating it. I think because I started eating sandwiches for lunch, so I didn't want to have like bread for two meals of every day. But just the typical bread with toast with potatoes, toast with peanut butter and sliced banana, chia seeds, and cinnamon. Good, simple protein, carbs, seeds, breakfast. Great. And then leftovers of the snacks that I used in my video on Friday. So I finished the rest of the veggies in that little bag, dipping them in the peanut butter and raisins. And yeah, very fascinating. No. And then for lunch, I found this smoky maple bacon flavored tempeh strips that I was like, these have been in here for a really long time. I should use them. And so I was like, okay, well, I'll make like a little salad with them because we have a lot of spinach that I need to be eating. So I tossed it up in the pan with a little bit of oil and some salt and pepper and some barbecue sauce. And if you like tempeh, I think it's good. This way, I thought it was pretty good. I'm not a huge fan of tempeh, but I do like it. It's just not like one of my favorite. Like I would prefer like tofu over it. But I do think it's good in like sandwiches and stuff. Anyways, I put it on a salad with spinach, avocado, broccoli, apples. I ended up putting some like Italian dressing on it a little later because it was a little too dry. And then I had one of those little balls from the video and a little bit of Cascadian Farms brand. I had a little bit of that before I went to the movies with Casey. And at the movies, I brought the balls and Casey brought grapes. We saw Ingrid Goes West. I recommend it if you love Aubrey Plaza like we do. Interesting movie, interesting concept, interesting perspective of a story to show. And when I got home, I made this milkshake kind of thing. We had a little bit of the PB and cookies, Ben and Jerry's ice cream left over. And I wanted like a milkshake, but I didn't want to eat like a ton of ice cream. So I put some ice cream, like maybe one scoop of ice cream, and then a little bit of frozen banana, which I think is a really good idea. Oh, and almond milk, probably. Which I think is a really good idea, like to, if you want a milkshake, but you don't want like a ton of ice cream, to like mix in just a little bit of ice cream and then put some like frozen bananas so it's not quite as bad. But obviously like some flavors work better with banana than others. Like this one worked okay. but like the Cherry Garcia one would probably be better, or like just a plain like chocolatey one, chocolatey ice cream. Doesn't have to be Ben and Jerry's, that's what I'm thinking of now, but like a chocolate ice cream, and you mix it with banana, that'd be really good. And then me and Casey both ate, Casey and I, we ate the leftover chickpea salad and dipped these crackers in it. These are also from the Mediterranean market, as you can tell. I like that place. Just like little crackers, they had like herbs and shit in them, and we dipped them. And this is, we were watching Bob's Burgers, and I just wanted to show, because this is one of the best scenes of the show. One of the best. One of the best, my friends. I'm going to link it below so you can watch it, because it's really funny.
Damn it. The things are not going great with Tony. Haven't been going great with Tony for a long time, you know? Tony's hot, but maybe it's time for me to just settle.
No. But look at me.
And then Sunday morning, I made a smoothie with bananas and strawberries and almond milk, and then I put in, well, I don't know why I didn't film myself doing it, but at some point I must have put cocoa powder in here. I think I put some protein powder too, and then it was pretty good, but the strawberries weren't really ripe enough, and I didn't realize that until I had already blended it, and there was a lot of strawberries in it, so I ended up adding some maple syrup, which I try not to do, because it's like a smoothie, like it's already a bunch of sugar of like the fruits. You shouldn't have to add more. You shouldn't have to do like added sugars, you know? But the strawberries just weren't sweet enough, so I just had to. I can't take it, man. Chocolate needs to be sweet. Then as a snack, I just ate the rest of this tempeh stuff, because your girl's hungry. And then as another snack, I ate another half of pita round. Another half of a pita round. And this is literally the same snack as the other day that I showed you. Like, I don't really need to explain it. And then for dinner, I made a sandwich with a veggie burger. Same veggie burgers I always have. Literally, how many would I eat in a week have these burgers been in? Probably all of them. And then I had a mango. Actually, I shared it with Casey. But I ate most of it, so. This night we watched, what's it called? Masterminds. I had a free Redbox movie. Masterminds with Zach Galifianakis and Kristen Wiig. And honestly, the first half of the movie, I was like, I don't like this movie. Like, I'm really saddened because I love all these actors. But halfway through, it got pretty lit, and it was, I liked it. The second half, I liked the movie. It was good. Once Jason Sudeikis came in, it was a good movie from then on. And that's it. That's the whole video. If you expected more, I'm not really sorry, because you shouldn't expect that in the first place from me. You dumb, silly, stupid person. This is my dog. I love her. And she says thanks as well for watching my video. So, if you want to see more videos like this, you should probably subscribe now, because the subscribe button won't be there after now. So you have to click it now, or you won't ever be able to subscribe. And like this video if you liked it. That's also a thing. And comment your thoughts. Comment which ones of your friends are thoughts. See you later. Goodbye. Love you.
Goodbye.